You will lead us onward from every corner of the world. All the nations gather. Great indeed are your works, O Lord, now and evermore. Great indeed are your works, O Lord, now and evermore.
Good morning, dear friends.
Good morning, Father.
Today we have Father Anthony Paul amongst us. He is from Andhra. He is a Jesuit.
The Lord brought out his people with joy, his chosen ones with shouts of rejoicing. Hallelujah. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, it is a great joy for me to come and celebrate Mass here in this great church, because when I was doing my ministry, the ministry is packed with Goans. Therefore, I know some of them might belong to this parish. Therefore, it gives me a great joy to come and celebrate Mass. Thank you, and I'll pray for your parish and all the parishioners' intentions. Let us recall to our mind our failures and sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my faults. To my most grievous faults. Therefore, I ask this Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth
peace to people of goodwill.
We praise you, we bless you,
we adore you,
we glorify you,
we give you thanks
for your great glory.
Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father,
Lord Jesus Christ,
only begotten Son,
Lord God, Lamb of God,
Son of the Father,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world,
receive our prayer.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father,
have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One,
you alone are the Lord,
you alone are the Most High,
Jesus Christ,
with the Holy Spirit,
in the glory of God the Father.
Amen. Let us pray. O God, who by the abundance of your grace give increase to the peoples who believe in you, look with favor on those who you have chosen, and clothe with the blessed immortality, those reborn through the sacrament of baptism, through Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the priests and the elders and the scribes saw the boldness of Peter and John and perceived that they were uneducated common men, they wondered and they recognized that they had been with Jesus. But seeing the man that had been healed standing beside them, they had nothing to say in opposition. But when they had commanded them to go aside out of the council, they conferred with one another, saying, "What shall we do with these men? For that a notable sign has been performed through them is manifest to all the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and we cannot deny it. But in order that it may spread no further among the people, let us warn them to speak no more to anyone in this name. So they called them and charged them not to speak or teach at all in the name of Jesus. But Peter and John answered them, "Whether it is right in the sight of God to listen to you rather than to God, you must judge. For we cannot but speak of what we have seen and heard." And when they had further threatened them, they let them go, finding no way to punish them because of the people, for all men praised God for what had happened. The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Our response for the psalm shall be, "I will thank you, Lord, for you have given answer." Please repeat.
I will thank you, Lord, for you have given answer.
Alleluia. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love has no end. The Lord is my strength and my song. He was my savior. There are shouts of joy and victory in the tents of the just. Please repeat. I will thank you, Lord, for you have given answer. The Lord's right hand has triumphed. His right hand raised me up. The Lord's right hand has triumphed. I shall not die. I shall live and recount his deeds. I was punished. I was punished by the Lord, but not doomed to die. Our response?
I will thank you, Lord, for you have given answer.
Open to me the gates of holiness. I will enter and give thanks. This is the Lord's own gate where the just may enter. I will thank you, for you have given answer and you are my savior. A response.
I will thank you, Lord, for you have given answer.
Please stand up for the gospel acclamation.
Alleluia, alleluia, give thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, give praise to his name.
This day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and are glad.
Alleluia, alleluia, give thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, give praise to his name.
So that I may boldly proclaim your gospel. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus rose early on the first day of the week, he appeared first to Mary Magdalene, from whom he had cast out seven demons. She went and told those who had been with him, as they mourned and wept. But when they heard that he was alive and had been seen by her, they would not believe it. After this, he appeared in another form to two of them, as they were walking into the country. And they went back and told the rest, but they did not believe. Afterward, he appeared to the 11 themselves as they sat at table, and he upbraided them for their unbelief and hardness of heart, because they had not believed those who saw him after he had risen. And he said to them, "Go into the whole world and preach the gospel to the whole creation." The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, there are two categories of people before and after resurrection of Christ. especially the categories of the people whom I meant was disciples. These disciples, during Jesus' time, they had different expectations. Judas Iscariot, he was a nationalist, he wanted to be a great, he wanted to redeem from Romans. And two of them, Andrew's mother, came to Jesus and she told him, please place on your right and left side my children. And Peter and all the other disciples, they just merely followed Jesus. Oh, Jesus performing miracle, wow. Oh, he's doing great, wow. Many are people following him, wow. But when the time came for Jesus to be handed over to the scribes, Pharisees, and Sadducees in Gethsemane, when he asked them to pray, sit and pray for me, what happened to the same desire? What happened to the zeal for these disciples? They just slept off. And when he was handed over, they ran away. One of Jesus' favorite disciples, he said, I do not know Jesus. I do not know him. I do not know who he was. That is first stage of discipleship. The same disciples, my dear friends, after the resurrection, who ran first towards the tomb? It was Peter. As soon as he heard, he said he didn't even walk, he ran. After the resurrection, after a few experiences, these disciples, those who were shivering, they came out boldly talking to the entire world. Come what may, people considered them foolish. People were humiliating them. What happened to the second set of disciples? They were boldly, courageously going and preaching to the whole nation, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, I baptize you. Saint Augustine says, we are Easter Christians and our song should be Alleluia. Whenever we don't sing Alleluia during Lent, we are passive, we are mourning, we are contemplating and reflecting on God's passion. But on the day of the resurrection, Easter, we all start singing Gloria, Alleluia, which means we are rejoicing. We are happy. We are joyful. That should be the attitude of any Christian. We are not mourning Christians. Mourning period is only a short period, but we are rejoicing Christians. We are Easter Christians. We are joyful Christians in the midst of humiliations, in the midst of persecutions, in the midst of all these trials and troubles. We are rejoicing Christians. We might have seen many people here in Goa. We are peaceful. But whereas when we go to the northern country, northern part of our country, they cannot openly come and say in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Many retaliations, attacks, bomb explosions. They cannot come out themselves. How blessed we are. But given to this blessing period, how many of us are Easter Christians, joyful Christians, rejoicing Christians? Sometimes, once I went to the restaurant, when I started saying in the name of the, with some of my friends, before the meals, when I started saying grace in the name of the Father and Son and the Holy Spirit, we continued the prayer. These guests who have invited me, Father, why do you want to show off your prayer even in the restaurant? Some of them, they don't like. They want to hide their rejoice. They want to hide their joy. They want to hide their happiness of being Christians. Dear friends, people may look at us. People may think something else. But when we have Jesus Christ in our heart, when we have resurrected Christ in our hearts, when we have this Easter candle following us and leading us and guiding us, let us not be shy. Let us not be ashamed. Let us always remain Easter Christians, joyful Christians, and rejoicing Christians.
Father, take the gifts we bring. Listen to the prayer we sing. Sanctify our sacrifice from heaven above. Draw us close to you, we pray. By the bread we give this day, may we live by this great mystery of love. Take this bread and take this wine, offered here, O Lord divine. Take our hearts and make them yours, O Lord, we pray. Make our faith and hope increase. Let our charity bring peace, so that we may spread your love along the way.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, for he is a true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he destroyed our death. By rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel down. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Savior of the world, for by your cross.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one with the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Philip Neri Ferrer, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the may that give us this day, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the peace of Christ.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace.
But through loving mercy, be for me protection in mind and body and a healing remedy. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is
of you who have been baptized in Christ have put on Christ. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And my part too quick information. The first information is being grateful to God. And I express my sincere gratitude to all the fathers who have given me the blessed opportunity to serve the Mass here. And the other information is for you, dear brothers and sisters. Let us not be a passive Christians. Let us remain always joyful Christians. Let us carry that Christ resurrected joy in us, not just merely attending Mass. Let us experience the joy and the love of Christ and go and proclaim the word of God through our actions. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. The Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Oh, great. You're